Hello and welcome to the Rising Stars of Comedy. I'm Akriti Tyagi. Mark Twain very wisely said, wrinkles should merely indicate where the smiles have been. Our guest for today very aptly justifies age is no bar adage. He is one of the oldest comedians in the circuit today, who might have gotten in very late in the day, but is surely going places. Please welcome Atul Khatri.
Hi guys, my name is Atul Khatri and I am 46 years old. You know, usually I get a clap over here. Because at the age of 46, I am perhaps one of India's oldest English stand-up comic. In fact, I'm so old, or rather some of these guys in our trade are so young that backstage they get confused. Should we call him dude or should we call him dad?
Thank you so much for being a part of the show, sir.
Thank you so much, Akriti.
How did comedy happen for a computer engineer?
As I always say, it was midlife crisis.
Okay.
I started late. I started doing comedy just 3 years back, actually. Mm-hmm. And I used to always read funny. I mean, I used to like reading funny stuff.
Yeah.
You know, I used to like one of my oldest collections of magazines I used to have. I used to read were Mad magazines.
Okay.
Which Alfred E. Newman, if you know about
it.
And that was really, I mean, from a young age, I started reading that. And somehow she always like fun, you know, going for funny movies, funny plays, not the serious types. And Facebook, I started writing funny posts, and that's how sort of, I think some friends used to say, you are very funny, you give your opinion in a very funny way, we like to read news through your posts, you know, and things like that. So why don't you try your hand at stand-up comedy? So it was actually 3 years back, it was actually a New Year resolution.
Okay.
I thought, let me do something different with my life. And in Jan 2012, I decided I'll do something, and I took part in the first open mic, which hit on 3rd February 2012.
Okay.
I didn't tell anybody. I just told my wife about it. Because, you know, the fear of bombing on stage was there. Didn't tell my children also. Told my children that we are going out for dinner.
Okay.
And wrote a set, went there, and as the usual open micer should, I was shivering. My legs were shivering. My hands were shivering. My throat became dry.
Yeah.
But I did pretty well there. I won that open mic.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it was my first open mic and I won it and I was very happy. And people said, no, you're quite funny. And as you know, there's no money in comedy.
Yeah.
So the prize for that was Karan, who was the organizer for that, Karan Talwar of Shits and Giggles, SNG comedy. He gave me a spot in another of his regular spots.
Okay.
And that's how it basically started. And I started doing more open mics and more stage time. I started writing more. And that's how it actually happened here.
All my friends think, amazing, man, amazing. You know, you become a stand-up comic at the age of 47. You know, 40s is the new 20s. 40s is the new 20s. No. 40s is 40s, 20s is 20s. Because I was not too happy getting into my 40s. Because first thing which happens when you get into your 40s, your eyesight goes, you know. One day before my 40th birthday, I had perfect 10 on 10 vision. Next day turned 40 and suddenly couldn't see Savita Bhabhi on my laptop. And it's a very funny kind of an eyesight. I can go to a party and spot the bra strap color and a shade of a lipstick of a woman in a dark room 200 meters away. Lekin SMS nahi padha jate na kaise lag rahe.
But as I mentioned, you're obviously going places. Now, you know, one gets to see you literally traveling all over the country and abroad and performing and doing quite well for yourself.
Sure.
You've still kept your day job. Are you hedging your bets?
Not really, but you know, I think I'm probably not yet got to that idea because I've been doing that day job. It's my own company. I'm a CEO of an IT company and I've been doing that job since last so many years.
Okay.
And I enjoy that as well. But I think right now the stand-up comedy scene in India is really taking off. You know, it's just, we are just at the tip of the iceberg.
Sure.
You know, it's just 4 or 5 years old, the industry. So it would be foolish that I don't get on to this bandwagon.
Of course.
So that's how actually I'm, thanks to today technology, you know, all your emails, everything is on your smartphone today, you know, and your reports you can get on your smartphone and things like that. So I've been able to manage both.
Balance both,
you know. I don't know how it is going to be in the future, I don't know. But as of now, I'm balancing both,
One gets to see sometimes that, you know, when parents decide to do something out of the ordinary, which children are not used to, and they decide to follow their passions, children can be a little, embarrassed about what parents do.
Yeah.
You know, did you have to face that with your kids?
Yeah, actually, I totally understand what you're saying. Your kids really get embarrassed when friends come and, parents come and dance at their parties or try to act cool and things like that. Mm-hmm. But somehow stand-up comedy itself is fairly cool.
Yeah.
They know how difficult it is. They had been for comedy shows before.
Mm-hmm.
And when they saw their dad going up and doing it, and they laughed at it and they found it very funny. And now it happens that when I'm performing at shows where their friends are sitting and their friends click my photograph and Snapchat it to them or WhatsApp it to them, ke, hey, your dad is performing and it's damn cool and all. So I think they're loving it, actually, to be honest with you. And I think for me also, because they realized it that your dad could do something so different at the age of 44, 45, that I think they look up to me. And I think they're I'm not getting the word, but their thing about their dad, you know, can do this, I think that makes them feel a little proud in some way.
I read once that you had posted that you wet a lot of your material through your younger daughter.
Yes, I
Is it to tap into the younger audience?
No, so what happens is that my younger daughter, my wife actually, so generally how do you test out a new material? That's always a thing, you know.
You do it on the family, your guinea pig.
Yeah, they are my guinea pig. So I make them sit in the room.
Okay.
My wife, as being a regular wife, she just cares, like, say what you want. Like, and it's very indifferent towards me. So both my daughters, I feel that the younger daughter has got a slightly humorous streak in her.
Hmm.
So I make her sit and I run through my material and I just see her, reactions. If she laughs out loud, that means I will get the same reactions
outside there.
Sometimes she says, no, this is funny. Oh, no, this is too much. This is too dark.
Okay.
Or ew, and all those kind of comments, reactions you get.
Yeah.
So it obviously helps you to get some kind of a first reaction when you've written a set for the first time.
Sure.
I won't drop it just because of that. I will go and try it on stage once, twice.
Mm.
But obviously there's reaction. I mean, also, my younger daughter, she has given me some of my lines also. You
okay.
So like, I remember doing a line, like I had a thing about, I talk about Sindhis, hair growing out of the ears, hair growing out of the ears, hair growing out of the chest. And by mistake, I said chest growing out of the hair while saying it.
Okay, okay.
He says, no, Dad, keep that. That's very funny,
mm-hmm.
Because it sort of flips it, chest growing out of the hair. Yeah. So anyway, so she gave me that line. And whenever I use it, she comes back and says, Dad, you have to pay me royalty for that line.
I'm a Sindhi married to a Punjabi, two of the hairiest communities in India. Obviously, it was a love marriage. Common love for hair. We met at a medical shop. We were both buying Gillette together.
Do you think as Indians we have a sense of humor?
I think we have.
Okay.
We have a sense of humor. It's only that we are sometimes scared to exhibit it. So for example, I do a lot of corporate shows. And people just don't laugh there. Because they're in a corporate environment.
Their bosses would be sitting.
Their bosses are sitting. Their female colleagues are sitting.
Yeah, yeah.
Just the word of the mention, sex could squirm them,
Yeah.
Even if you say that so-and-so is a member of the opposite sex, just the word you said, the word sex.
Yeah.
This, this squirm and you do and things like that, so all that thing happened. But the same guys, you go right, go out, you pick up the phone, go through the photo gallery, you'll see the amount of smut and rubbish which is there, And the same people would come to a comedy show at the comedy store with their wives and laugh their hearts out. But because they're in that environment and all that, but see, you have to also understand, I'm not really blaming them.
Yeah.
It's the, they're watching comedy again for first time, second time. It's a responsibility in all of us to see that we, don't scare them away. We don't, we play to their rules. If they say, okay, like most of the corporates where we perform, they have simple rule, don't talk about sex, don't talk about religion, don't talk about politics. Politics, okay, you can do a little bit. But, so you keep to that game because you don't really want to scare them. You can say, I'm going to say this. I'm a comedian. I have my voice. Yes, you have your voice for sure.
But not to offend somebody.
Really, I mean, we are comedians. We are there to, make people laugh. We get paid for that, Not really to offend them or to, scare them away from the genre of comedy, actually.
I think the drinking age limit of 25 is correct. I mean, I'm talking as a parent because even I have two teenage children. Because at the age of 25, kids are grown up, they realize the value of money, and hopefully by then, earning enough to buy your own alcohol. I wouldn't want my 18-year-old child to come and tell me, Papa, daru ke liye paisa de. Tere ko dega to main kya piyega?
Ram Leela movie, the title had a problem with the title. The title changed four times. From Ram Leela, it became Ram-Leela to Gholiyon ki Ras Leela, Ram Leela to finally no title. Sanjay Leela Bhansali was fed up with all this. He said, so the name Ram Leela, should I get the name Sanjay Leela?